guys, welcome back to week four of our series called Legacy. And a legacy, we're learning, is something that is handed down from the past. And we're spending this month talking about the legacy that Jesus left us, which is the
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit. Yeah. That's right. So last week we learned how the Holy Spirit helps us do God's work. And you may know what's next, but
I think
let's do a
might be a little dance
song.
We'll sing
and dance.
Singing and dancing
about it.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise the Lord.
Okay, so, Mr. Brian, I think it's time that we're going to do a little test. I'm going to give you a test.
Okay.
Okay? Okay. So this test, you have the pencil and you have the paper, and I'm going to give you 1 minute to write down as many countries as you can think of, and maybe try to write them
whoa,
like...
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Do you know how long it's been since I looked at a globe?
Just guess. Just A through Z, start with A, and try to think of an A country.
Okay, I can do that.
And then go to B, and try to think of a B country. We can go down the alphabet, but you only have a minute, so you're not going to get them all. But
all right.
let me set my timer. Start thinking. I'm almost there. Ready, set, go.
All right.
Should I sing like a song? Na, 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 na. Oops. I don't know what that was. So how's your day going?
Shh.
Just talking to the people. We're getting bored. Stop it. They have to be real countries. I mean, you can skip a letter. Don't stop on, like, for example, the letter I, if you're stumped on something like Israel or something like that. Cheater. No? I think time's up.
Okay.
All right, how many did you get? What'd you got?
I got A through K, and I'm missing J.
Jamaica!
Impressed.
Oh my gosh. Kazakhstan, I'm impressed by that one. That was a good one, Jamaica, though.
I have Holland. I got Israel, thanks to her. And Algeria, Bolivia, Canada, Denmark, Fiji, and Ghana.
Good job. I don't have a map, but I think those are all real countries.
Let's hope so.
Okay. So, did you guys know that there are actually 195 countries in the world? Yeah. You had a lot to choose from. But that is a lot of different cultures and languages and traditions. And God cares for every single person in every single one of those countries. Isn't that crazy? So in today's Bible story, we are going to find out what Jesus wanted the disciples and us to do in the world. So let us not delay any longer. We are ready for the Bible story. Are you ready for the Bible story?
I am so ready.
Okay. So we're going to listen to Carl, and he's going to share with us the story and the big idea.
To you, Carl.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. Hey, it's me, Carl, and welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV! Hosted by Carl, where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV!
Hi, y'all. Thank you so much for tuning in today. I got great news for y'all. And I got bad news. Bad news. Bad news is, this is week 4 of our Legacy series. But the good news is, that means it's time for our week 4 Fantastic Fun Facts. Week 4 Fantastic Fun Facts is a segment where we like to talk about fun facts on week 4. Are you ready? I can't hear you. Still can't hear you. That's okay. Fun fact number 1. Do you know that it's impossible to hum while plugging your nose? Seriously, it's impossible. Try it. Isn't that crazy? Hopefully you'll never have to enter a humming contest underwater, am I right? Fun fact number 2. A bolt of lightning has enough electricity to toast 100,000 pieces of bread. Wow, that fun fact is shocking. I know it may not be the safest, but man, if you need a lot of toast quick, that's the route to go. Fun fact number 3. You can hear a blue whale's heartbeat from over 2 miles away. Let's see if there's any nearby. Gotcha. Sorry. All right, fantastic fun fact number 4. The largest snowflake ever was 15 centimeters wide. Wow. That's not that big. Hey, TJ.
What's going on, Carl, man? It's so good to see you, bro. What you up to these days?
Oh, well, you know, it's the 4th week of the series.
Did I miss fun fact time?
Not quite. We just said our last fact. And to be honest, it was not that fun.
Well, what was it?
The largest snowflake in the world was 15 centimeters wide.
Oh, well, that's not true anyway.
What are you talking about?
Go ahead and read it again.
Huh. Whoa, you're right. My bad, y'all. The largest snowflake ever recorded was 15 inches wide. Holy smokes, that's huge.
It sure is.
Could you imagine being in a snowstorm and the snowflakes are this wide? That would be terrifying, but exciting.
But you know what, Carl? If you like that, you definitely are going to like today's story. Man, it's wild.
I can't wait. Where's the story at?
It's in Acts chapter 2.
Okay, wait. Is that the Pentecost?
Yeah, it sure is.
Oh, I love this story. It starts off where all the disciples were gathered, and then a loud sound like a wind came from heaven.
Yep, and then the Holy Spirit filled the whole room. And then he began to fill each disciple with himself.
And then, wait. Is this the first time the disciples had the Holy Spirit with them?
It was. And that's one of the reasons why this story was so special.
Oh, yeah. And once they were filled with the Holy Spirit, they started speaking in different languages. Isn't that incredible?
It totally is. You see, the Holy Spirit is crazy powerful and helps us do amazing things. Do you remember what happened next?
How could I forget?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I think I might have forgotten.
It's all right, man. With a loud sound that came from heaven, it was so loud that people from all over were wondering what was going on.
So they came and gathered with the disciples?
Yeah, And these were people from everywhere, all different types of countries. So, you know, they were speaking all types of languages. But they heard the disciples speaking in their own language.
Everyone did? So they were all able to understand what was being said?
Yes, sir. It was so cool.
I bet. So what was being said?
Well, Peter had begun sharing the message of Jesus Christ with everyone, and people were blown away by everything that had happened. Then, around 3,000 people gave their lives to Jesus, was baptized, and filled with the Holy Spirit that day.
On that day?
Yep. It was one of the greatest days ever.
Oh, well, that's a big bummer.
What? What are you talking about, man? This is good news.
How? The disciples got the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
3,000 other people's got the Holy Spirit?
Yeah.
And that all happened on just Pentecost?
Of course.
Well, newsflash, DJ, I wasn't there.
So
that means I don't get the Holy Spirit. I missed out. I'm always a day late and a dog collar short.
It's a dollar short?
Don't start with me, TJ. I'm going through something.
Just relax. You're okay, man. Listen, that day was just the beginning. It was the beginning of something huge.
What? What did it mean?
It meant that from then on, salvation, grace, unconditional love, and the Holy Spirit are all gifts that everyone can receive.
Seriously?
Of course. That's what's awesome about God. The Holy Spirit is for everyone.
Oh, TJ, that is good news because guess what? That is our big idea. Yeah. Today's big idea is the Holy Spirit is for everyone.
So let's say it out loud on the count of three then. One,
two, three.
The Holy Spirit is for everyone.
Yeah. Good job, everyone. Let me tell you what, TJ. I am so relieved to find out that the Holy Spirit is for everyone.
Me too, man. Man, listen, it's awesome. Oh, look. Looks like we have one more fun fact.
No way.
Guess what?
What?
Chicken butt.
That is pretty good. See you next week, kiddos. TJ. I don't think you can say butt on here.
Thank you for watching and tune in next week for a new episode of RoTV.
Thanks, guys. Wow. Can you imagine being suddenly able to speak other languages?
So cool.
That would be crazy. Imagine meeting a friend from another country who doesn't speak the language you speak. How could you communicate with them if you didn't speak their language?
I think maybe Pictionary. Maybe some gestures. I think there's an app on the phones.
Oh, that's a now, good one. Yeah.
Maybe
Google Translate.
Yes.
Okay.
That'd be cool.
When the Holy Spirit appeared to the disciples, it was a time when their city was filled with people visiting from countries all over the world who spoke different languages. So while a bunch of Jesus's followers gathered together, the Holy Spirit gave them the ability to speak each other's languages. Isn't that crazy? It gave the disciples the opportunity to share the good news about Jesus with everyone without the language differences, the barriers between them stopping them. Even though all of Jesus' followers at first came from a single culture, God wanted them to know that it didn't stop there. God was giving the disciples the power through the Holy Spirit to start doing amazing things beyond their power and beyond their borders because God was inside of them. When anyone believes in Jesus, they too receive the Holy Spirit. And when we have the Holy Spirit in us, it's like having God's help wherever we go. Now, let's send Sparky, our lab rat friend, some scripture to read, okay? Let's put that verse into our special time travel machine. Let's make whatever noise you think that time travel machine should work. And first, we need the verse beamed to us to put into that time machine, so... Look at that. Isn't that amazing?
Magical.
All right, here we go. Week four.
Pop it.
Pop it. Insert.
Chomp, chomp.
Hello again, friends. Ooh, ooh, it sounds like I'm getting a special scripture message in my time travel machine. Let's see what it says. It's from Brian and Carol. They want me to read from the Bible, Psalms 139, verses 7 through 10. Okay, okay. Let me look it up here. Psalms is in the Old Testament of the Bible. The Bible has two sections, the Old and the New Testament. Each Testament has books, and each book has chapters and verses. So I'm looking in the Old Testament of the book of Psalms, chapter 139. That's the big 139. And verses 7 through 10, the little 7 through 10. Okay, I think I have it. Here we go. I can never escape from the Spirit. I can never get away from your presence. If you go up to heaven, you are there. If I go down to the grave, you are there. If I ride the wings of the morning, if I dwell on the farthest oceans, even there, your hand will guide me and your strength will support me. That is so awesome. Let's hear what Brian and Carol have to say about it. Bye, kids. See you next week.
Well, thank you, Sparky. So, who is the Spirit that is being talked about here? The Psalm reminds us that the Holy Spirit is everywhere, and we cannot hide from the Holy Spirit at all. How does that make you feel? That should make you feel pretty good, huh?
Pretty darn good inside.
Yeah, you shouldn't want to hide from the Spirit. Maybe it makes you feel a little afraid because you think God is just waiting around for you to make a mistake. You think so? Ready to catch in the act? Mm-hmm. No, that's not actually the case. The Holy Spirit is everywhere because God loves you and wants to be with you. And there is no place that is out of reach for the Holy Spirit. And I think that makes me feel safe.
Me too.
Yeah. And that brings us back to our big idea for the day. Carl already shared it with us, but do you remember what it was? I think I need a drum roll. Okay, here it is on the screen. That's a wonderful drum roll. Thank you. And it is... The Holy Spirit is for everyone. Each one of us is different. We all look different. We speak different languages. And we have a variety of different cultures. But even though we're so different, there is one thing that we have in common, and that is God, and that He loves us all. And God has provided us a way for all of us to love God back, and that is through the Holy Spirit.
The Holy Spirit.
Come on. The Holy Spirit's for everyone.
All right, guys. Thanks again for joining us today. It's been awesome. As always, don't forget to stay connected with us. We've got our YouTube page and our Facebook and our Instagram account, and there are so many ways out there to get connected and activities to do with your family. So as we finish up today, let's review once again our monthly memory verse. It is from Romans chapter 8, verse 14, and it says, "For all who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God." Again, that's Romans chapter 8, verse 14. So let's watch this quick video on how to sign this in sign language.
Romans 8:14. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God.
All right, great job, everyone. Do you guys all have it memorized by now? It's ready? You're ready? I hope you do, but if not, keep practicing. Practice with your parents and your siblings and your neighbor and the mailman and your dog. I mean, practice, 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 okay? So we are going to go ahead and wrap up tonight, today, this morning.
Whenever
you're watching it. I mean, it could be middle of the night with a prayer. We're going to pray. Let's pray. Dear God, we are so grateful that your love includes all of us. Thank you for giving us the Holy Spirit so we're never, ever truly alone. Help us to be the ones who remind the world that the Holy Spirit is for everyone. Amen. All right, guys, have a great weekend. Have a great week ahead.
See you guys.
See ya.